all a very healthy and happy life. Let's begin with today's topic. As you know very well, Vache, we have started out with number four, that is chemical bonding and molecular structure. Okay? In this topic, we have studied about the leaf structure, we have studied about the bond parameters, that is, what is our bond length, what is bond angle, and in these trending, in this, the same manner, we have left with two topics, that is bond dissociation energy, and the last one is bond order. All right? I have given you a brief idea about the bond dissociation energy also in our previous class. Let's see it more elaborately, and then we will complete our topic and start the new topic. All right? Let's begin with the topic. The topic tells you the bond enthalpy, or we can also say it bond dissociation energy. Right? Now the point is, why do we call it bond dissociation energy, or why do we call it bond bond enthalpy? The bond enthalpy is something which is defined as the energy required to break down bond between the compound, right? For example, if you have any kind of compound known as ester, is over here. So the energy required to break down the bond OH is going to be dissociation energy. Same as if our bond we are breaking down, that is known to be bond dissociation enthalpy. Okay. Now the point here is, I have told you that bond enthalpy is something which gives you, which tells you about the bond strength. So can we say, more is the bond dissociation energy, stronger is the bond. Can I call that? Definitely. Why is it so? Because this is a normal thing. If my bond is strong in nature, we need more energy to break it down. We need more energy to dissociate it. Right? So I would like to say bond dissociation energy would be higher, the bond would be stronger. All right. The another point, this was my first point. The second point, I have told you, Bache, that if I'm talking about the water, what happens? The bond dissociation energy of first order is something different. That is, if from water I am breaking down H positive plus OH negative, right? So the bond dissociation energy for breaking down is 4,333 kilojoules per mole. That is something different. But if we break down the another bond from OH, that means agar main ye bond break karna cha rahi hu, so it has something different energy. Suppose it has 433 kilojoules per mole. So now the point arises, why is it happening? So we are having oxygen hydrogen, we are having oxygen hydrogen. So dono ke beech mein itna zyada variation kyun hai? And the answer is, the reason is, whenever we break down our first bond, what actually happening over here, the oxygen and hydrogen is breaking down easily. But if there is OH left, there is a lone pair of oxygen and the hydrogen do not have any kind of repulsion over here. Kyun? Last time kya tha? Hydrogen dusre wale hydrogen ke sath repulsion create kar raha tha. But right now there is no repulsion, and the oxygen is something which is attracting the hydrogen. That means my environment is changing. बात समझ में आ रही है भाई? पहली बात तो ये है कि इसके पास कोई repulsion नहीं है. दूसरी बात, oxygen has lone pairs, and we know that lone pairs means electron. Electron means negative charge, and hydrogen means positive charge. So can we say both my negative and positive charge, they are attracting each other? When they are attracting each other, can we call that after some time the hydrogen and oxygen attraction would be high? Agar unke beech mein bond strong hoga, attraction high hogi, to usko break karne ke liye hame zyada energy ki zarurat padegi. That is known to be bond dissociation enthalpy for second bond. Clear? Now the point here is, we have two different type of energies. For water, whom should I call? This is my bond dissociation energy, right? Water, whom should I call? That yes, my case, I have done the average of both the energies. That is, suppose this is happening to be 350 kilojoule per mole, that would be known as the bone dissociation energy for both. Okay? This was the topic, but I have explained you a little bit also, but I could not explain it in a very detailed manner. So I have taught you this in today's class. So that was all. Now, we have done about the bone dissociation enthalpy. What do you mean by another bone parameter? That is, we have bone order. Let's check it out about bone order. What do you mean by bone order? See that also. Bone order, hame kya batana cha raha hai? Just check it out. Okay. So, I would like to say, bone order is the representation of a Lewis structure, definitely yes, of a Lewis structure. In which we can determine number of bones present between the atoms. Baat samajh mein aa rahi hai bhai? I'm saying the bond order is something which explains the number of bonds present between two atoms or two or more than two atoms between the molecule. For example, nitrogen N2. It says it has nitrogen, triple bond nitrogen. That means bond order is 3. Right? If I'm talking about HCl, there is hydrogen fluorine. That means bond order is 1. Clear? If I'm talking about, for example, C2H4, that is ethylene. That means CH2 double bond CH2, bond order is 2. So we can easily calculate that bond order is something which tells us about the number of bonds present between the atoms or molecules. Now my point of interest is, I have told you about the bond order. Can we relate our all the parameters with each other? हमने bond length के बारे में study किया है, हमने bond order के बारे में study किया है, हमने bond dissociation energy के बारे में study किया है. Can we relate these old parameters to each other? Definitely yes. Let's see how is it possible. For calculating the bone dissociation energy and bone order relation, can I say my bone order is directly proportional to bone dissociation energy, or we can say bone enthalpy? एक ही बात है. Why? Simple सी बात है. That's a common thing. If I have a single bond, the energy required to break down a single bond would be, like to say, more would number the bond dissociation. Okay, so we can say the higher is the bond, the higher is the number of bonds, the higher is the bond dissociation energy. Clear? So we have studied about this first concept. Another one I would like to tell about the bond order. This was my first point. Second point, bond order is inversely proportional to bone length. That concept you will study in your higher classes, in class number 12, how bond order is inversely proportional to bone length. But I just want to tell you, if the bond is 1 over here, it would be easily related to each other. If my bond order is high, suppose I'm talking about 2 or 3, that means more number of electrons are required to make the bond. For example, main baat kar rahi hoon is nitrogen ki aur is nitrogen ki. They have total 3 pairs of electrons between them. So can I say, due to these more pair of electrons, the two atoms would be close to each other? Can I say? Definitely yes. क्यों? क्योंकि अगर उनको proximity same रखनी है, उनको closeness same रखनी है, for making the more bonds, they have to become more closer to each other. So if the higher would be the bone older, if the higher would be the number of bone present between them, the bone length would be short. The bone distance would be less. Why? Because they have to combine to each other, right? So we can easily say that bone order is inversely proportional to bone length. Clear? So this is the topic I want to explain to you. Another thing about bone order is that the isoelectronic species has same bond order. In chapter number 3, that is the periodic table, we have studied what are known to be isoelectronic species. I hope you have remembered. What is isoelectronic species? I hope aapko yaad ho, humne chapter number 3 mein kiya tha. Isoelectronic means same number of electrons. Isoelectronic means same number of electrons, right? That means the species which have the same number of electrons, they are known to be isoelectronic species. For example, I have example of fluorine and O2 negative. Yani mere paas hai F2 aur mere paas hai O2 negative. You know very well that fluorine is something which has 9 electrons, that means there would be total 18 electrons. Oxygen is something which has 8 plus 8, 16, and 2 negative means 2 more, that means 18 electrons, right? So they are the isoelectronic species F2 and O2 negative. Both of them have the same bond order, that is 1. Right, so we can say the isoelectronic species, that means the bond order is the same. Cool. All right, so now we have said about isoelectronic species also, about their bond order also. Let's take another example. If I have example of N2 and so CO, nitrogen. Abhi humne study kiya hai that nitrogen is the most strongest bond present in my inorganic chemistry. In my chemistry, N2 is something which is known to be the strongest compound. Why? Because they have the strong bond order, their energy is very high, so we need much energy to break down them. So we can say that they are the strong. Okay, so if I'm talking about nitrogen has number of electrons 7 plus 7 equals to 14. Carbon monoxide 6 plus same number of electrons, and both have same number of bond order also. Abhi humne study kiya hai N2 ke andar bond order kaun sa hai, 3. So CO must equals bond order of 3 also. Clear? So this is the beauty, this is the importance, how we can study about the bond order. Itne sare atoms ko hum relate kar sakte hain only on the basis of bond order or bond dissociation energy. Clear? Okay, so this was all about this topic, bond parameters. We have studied. Let's move with the next topic, resonance structure. I hope you have got the concept. If not, you can ask me after the completion of class, please. Okay. Topic of discussion is today resonance structure. What is resonance structure, guys? Why do we need to study resonance structure? What do you mean by resonance structure? Okay. First of all, the point is how do we come to the nature of resonance structure? That means I just want to ask to you, why do we need to study the topic resonance and what do it mean? First of all, resonance structure means we have taken so many examples of Lewis structure, right? We have seen Lewis structure of ozone, of carbon carbonate ion of carbon monoxide molecule and many more. So scientists have revealed that experiments have observed that only a single number of Lewis structure cannot explain all the qualities. And again, I'm saying only a single Lewis structure is inadequate, is insufficient to explain all the parameters of any atom or molecule. For example, if I'm talking about ozone, and we know very well ozone has three molecules, right? We have just done our new structure of ozone in our first lecture. So we know that ozone is something which has this type of structure in which oxygen and oxygen has oxygen 1, oxygen 2 has two bond, and oxygen 1, oxygen 3 has single bond. Moreover, they are present to bronze pairs. Okay, each one has some different type of bonds. Okay, now the point of my concern is when we have studied that the normal oxygen-oxygen bond lengths are 148 picometer. Yes, I just want to give you the exact data. The bond length of oxygen 1 and oxygen 3 is 148 picometer. And if I'm talking about the bond length of oxygen 1 and oxygen 2, since the bond order is 2, so bond length kya honi chahiye? Kam. Definitely less. So it is 121 picometer. So we have come to know that ozone is something which different molecules, three different type of bond length. Now the point is, when we have determined experimentally the ozone-oxygen length between ozone, it is found to be 128 picometers. Am I clear? I'm saying, जब हमने स्टडी किया वी हैव कम टू नो दैट ऑक्सीजन हैज 120 पिकोमीटर एंड 148 पिकोमीटर बट एक्सपेरिमेंटली फॉर द कंप्लीट ओजोन मॉलिक्यूल द ऑक्सीजन ऑक्सीजन बॉन्ड लेंथ इज फाउंड टू बी 128 पिकोमीटर नाउ द कंसेप्ट अराइजेस हाउ इज इट इवन पॉसिबल हाउ कैन वी से दैट इट हैज 128 पिकोमीटर सो फॉर रिमूविंग दिस कंफ्यूजन And for getting the more information, for getting the more clarity about the structure of such molecules which has more than single bond, we need resonance structure. Should I talk it again? Dobara suno. I'm saying for getting more clarity and for getting more information for the molecules who have more than single bond, we need resonance structure. Right? Let's see how the structure can be modified to give resonance structure. It is the same that my oxygen, which has a lone pair, this oxygen, single bond, the same thing ki baat kar rahi hu, which we have already given to us. This is 4 and this is 3 bond. Okay. Now the point here is I can easily write it by the combination of electrons, by the rearrangement of electrons into the reaction which will make you in this way. Baat samajh mein aa rahi hai? Suppose this is your first structure, suppose this is your second structure. I have nothing done. I have just replaced this double bond from one place to another place. मैंने इस double bond को यहाँ से यहाँ shift कर दिया. We can easily do so. Okay? We don't have any kind of objection in this particular topic because the oxygen is present. Oxygen is present, so double bond can be easily replaced because it has the same number of it. Okay? Now the same concept. 148. 121, 148. These were the two structures. So finally, we have done And I have said that this double bond is spread between the two oxygen. Now this oxygen have exactly 128 picometer bond. Here, this is known to be resonance structure. ये हमारी जितनी भी structure हैं, these all are known to be resonance structure. Resonance means similar. These all are similar structure, but we have just modified it. We have just represented it in a better way. जिसमें हमने double bond किसी पर भी show नहीं किया है. We have just said that this double bond is spread over all three molecules, and this particular structure is known to be canonical structure. This particular is known to be canonical structure. Am I clear? All three are known to be resonance hybrids. That means they are. A single Lewis. Hello. I was just telling. Hence, we can say resonance is something when a single Lewis structure is not sufficient to describe a molecule accurately. A number of structures, वो दो भी हो सकते हैं, वो तीन भी हो सकते हैं, that depends upon the double bond. A number of structures with similar energy. Similar position of nuclei, similar bonding and non-bonding electron pairs are taken as the canonical structure of hybrid, and this is known to be resonance structure. Clear? Okay, let's see. Just as I have given you the idea of oxygen, sorry, ozone molecule, which have the three type of resonance structure, and this one is known to be canonical structure. Same as it is, we can make for the carbonate molecule, we can make for the carbon monoxide molecule. That's the homework that we'll do definitely. Now the point here is, what are the advantages? हमने इतना कुछ पढ़ा है इसके बारे में, इतना कुछ सीखा है, इनको अलग अलग नाम दिए हैं, इसका बेनिफिट क्या है हमारे लिए? First of all, so definitely it gives us more clarity, it removes all the confusion experimentally, और theoretical सारी जो conditions हैं वो satisfy हो रही हैं. सबसे बड़ा advantage तो यही है. Other than that, I would like to say resonance stabilize the molecules because the energy of resonance hybrid or canonical structure, we can say it either resonance hybrid or canonical structure, the resonance hybrid or canonical structure energy is less than other two. Contain energy of resonance hybrid is less than other two. That means it is stabilizing my okay. All right. Okay, as you know very well that if I'm saying about the energy, if I'm talking about the energy concept, you know, lesser is the energy, higher is the stability. As you know, if we come energy is the stability hybrid, or we can say canonical structure is less than other two. So we will take that particular structure as a whole. That means resonance stabilizes the molecule. This is my first advantage. Second advantage is it gives us the average of a complete molecule, right? मतलब क्या है इस लाइन का भाई? इसका मतलब ये है जी कि इफ आई हैव डन अबाउट दिस ऑक्सीजन, इट टेल्स देयर इज डबल बॉन्ड ओवर देयर, देयर इज सिंगल बॉन्ड ओवर देयर, इसकी बॉन्ड लेंथ 121 है, इसकी बॉन्ड लेंथ 148 पिकोमीटर है, बट if I'm talking about complete average bond characteristics of a complete molecule, for example, the resonance structure, or sorry, no resonance structure, resonance hybrid, or the canonical molecule, that means it would give you the average value of all things. Bond length is 128 picometer. Bond order is 1.5, and many more things, right? So we can easily explain the resonance structure or canonical structure or the resonance hybrid, which leads to all these benefits for my reaction, for my compound. Yeah? So we have done the topic regarding the resonance structure. Let's have some doubts over here. But just a second. I would like to say, okay, first of all, I just want to tell you about some misconception about the resonance structure. The first misconception says to us that resonance structure, or we can say canonical structure, do not exist structure exists